also. Good afternoon. Private equity was touched by the previous panel and also from Apostolos, very rightly so. So I'll try to put some perspective in the discussion, though, from some numbers. First of all, let me present myself. My name is Takis Solomos. I'm a partner with the Helikonos Capital Partners. Who we are? We were founded in 2009. We have offices in Athens, in Luxembourg, in New York City, and Bucharest. We manage two funds with approximately $90 million US dollars in assets, and we plan this to increase that by slightly, let's say by $10 million by Q1 2019. And we have done with our investees, we have tried to take them outside of the country and lead them to stock exchanges around the world, bring them over in the United States, and provide them advisory for M&A. So I would like to underline the importance and the opportunity, in my opinion, as Apostol said in the previous panel about the private equity opportunity in Greece. We know that there have been a crisis for 10 years, but the last year we have seen a recovery, which is of course fragile in current year. However, the current GDP per capita is close to EU average still, and this is a country of 190 billion euros. So there are numbers behind the economy. This is not a small economy. We have seen, of course, that the main issue in Greece is that the banks are taking practically capital out of the economy. If back in 2013, the total net bank loans in the car market were 230 billion, 2017 were 200 billion. So that means that practically there are 30 billion that have been taken outside of the economy. The private sector market in Greece is very limited. As Apostolos said, there is no significant competition in the market. All the availability of the local capital for the SME sector is more or less 400 million euros, and that is there are some assumptions behind that also. Again, Greece is an SME country. Practically, if you don't want to invest in SMEs, there are no companies to invest. There are only 388 large companies exist in Greece. Most of them are subsidiaries of multinationals or are large companies listed in the Athens Stock Exchange. So there are approximately 700,000 companies that are part of the SME, let's say, environment, and they are available for people to dig in and try to identify the opportunities. As I said, the banks have contracted the net debts to the market, so 30 billion have been practically taken outside of the country, and there is no liquidity to tap this holder. So, what's actually the opportunity then? So, we see that there is a limited competition on the investment side. Despite of, in a previous panel, someone mentioned that there is significant FDI in Greece. Of course, this is not the reality. There is some FDI, mostly in the hotel and the tourism sectors, but in the rest of the economy, there is no real foreign direct investment compared with the pre-crisis years. But of course, please bear in mind that Greece never managed to attract any significant foreign direct investment anyway. It was always have been in the, let's say, bottom end of the OECD list for foreign direct investment attraction for the last 30 years. So there's no foreign direct investment. There is a limited presence or limited investment from global private equity groups because there is no scale. As we heard from the gentleman before, the international private equity groups, they are looking for major investments in the tens or hundreds of millions. So this type of opportunities, I'm afraid, there aren't that available or that many in the market. And again, the local entrepreneurs are still not willing to invest. And of course, if there is the credit contractions that we discussed a bit earlier. Of course, there is the Greece needs equity. We all understand this because of the level of the NPLs that the four systemic banks carries in their balance sheet. And another major characteristic is that still business entrepreneurs are very reluctant to go and invest themselves, and hence go after and seek a co-investor. They are still believe that the economy is fragile, and they need to be very certain before they engage to investments or co-partner with someone else in a business plan. Of course, as Apostolos also mentioned, there are the restructuring opportunities, and the NPL resolution that all the country is looking forward is going to unleash a significant number of deals that that will enhance definitely the deal flow that is going to be available in the economy. The microeconomic factors, I only have 3 minutes still, so I'll go very quickly. We have seen that the economy really managed to be sustainable and work very hard in several, let's say, sectors. Mining have been still growing, energy, the food and the tourism sector. So we feel that these sectors are still an excellent opportunity for investment from a private equity perspective. And on the other hand, we have seen that the companies really tried extremely hard to enhance their financial performance the last 10 years. So we see that there has been constant improvement in the EBITDA margin of most of the companies that are operating in Greece. So entrepreneurs really managed to, let's say, fight back the crisis, fight back the issues, and work hard on their P&Ls and try to enhance their profitability. There are challenges, of course, and opportunities. A great opportunity is that there is available talent in Greece these days that is willing to work hard to make things happen, which is a great news for people that do what we are doing. And of course, from the other perspective, there is the liquidity squeeze that we'll know, and the valuations that are very, let's say, towards the lower end of the spectrum. There is a number of maturing family businesses that they need to become extrovert and try to tackle all the problems of the local economy. Our latest fund is Helikonos 2. We currently have 60 million euro under management. This is a generalist fund. We expect this to grow to 70 million in the following months. As I said, we feel that there is a major opportunity in the private sector, private equity sector in Greece, especially or only in the SME side of the equation. And we are very willing to work with anybody that wants to take an opportunity to enlarge their businesses and try to do it together. Thanks so much for your time, and I hope this makes the private equity opportunity, along with the previous presentations, more clear to you all. Thanks so much.